We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we are talking KBS putter shafts. We've done loads of testing recently, Neil, with drivers and irons, and the story that we keep coming across is improving the MOI of your driver or your irons by changing the shaft to a stability shaft.
Yep.
Essentially, that's what KBS have done with their newest putter shaft, the GPS.
Yeah, it's really, really clever, isn't it, Sam, and how they've done this? And it's something that probably a lot of the golfing population actually overlook. They're talking about stability, like you say, with the driver, the fairway woods, the irons, and now KBS are introducing it into the putters, because you'll be surprised how many people I see when coaching and fitting, really, how difficult it is, especially from your longer range putts, to actually hit the middle of the putter. You'll be surprised. So to have this little bit of stability, it's going to only help with improve performance.
Okay, so just to be clear, the KBS make four different putter shafts. The GPS is the first graphite putter shaft that the brand has made. And basically what they're saying is they can make it more resistant to twisting than what they can with a steel shaft of the same weight, which is absolutely incredible.
So clever. Something I thought wouldn't be possible, but it clearly is. Shall we have a little look through them, Sam? So it's obviously, we've got the stiffness there without adding the weight, which obviously also they've got that resistance in the twisting and the torque. Mm-hmm. So really what you're doing is it's giving the putter an MOI boost, isn't it? So your miss hits, your stability, you're going to be a little bit better with proximity to the hole.
Okay, so I think what I would say is if you're looking at buying a new putter or you want to refresh an old putter, you've got to consider a stability shaft nowadays, because KBS are not the first people that have done this. There's others out there, but it's the way that the market is going. And I love the way that KBS really talk about, you can compare the GPS compared to their steel putter shafts in the same way as the TGI versus the PGI graphite iron shaft. So the TGI is quite firm, it's got quite a stout feeling to it, it's quite fast, whereas the PGI, like the GPS, is much more of a melting feeling through the golf ball, you get more feel from it. Very, very popular with lady golfers, the PGI. If feel is your thing, if stability is your thing, then I think the GPS is probably your thing as well.
Yeah, definitely. And also worth mentioning, they're available in 8 different colours. They all look really smart. They're like this one here in white, looks slick, isn't it? Looks so good.
Okay, so that's pretty much everything that you need to know about the GPS. There's 3 other models, and something that I hadn't really realised, Neil, but if you've played tailor-made spider putters over the last decade, or if you play Bettinardi or even roll putters, there's a very, very good chance that you've been playing a KBS putter shaft anyway. Yeah. But let's just try and explain the difference between the 3 other models. So we've got the One Step.
Yeah, so you've got, again, huge stability in this. It's good for increased head weight, so you have your putters, generally your bigger footprint, your mallet type putters. Again, it's wanting to hold the face squarer through your off-center hits.
Okay, so good stability for a steel putter shaft.
Yeah.
Not against graphite.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's designed to transmit pure amplified feel with the reduction of the vibration through the shaft, because you do get that as well. I know, like, say if people blade an iron shot or anything, you get that vibration, especially on a cold winter morning. You still get that through the putter as well, and that's just limiting this a little bit down now. The parallel tip section can give you increased better feel. Mm-hmm. But you have got to remember that this is a One Step. You can see that, can't you, Sam? We were discussing this, weren't we? It is quite pronounced, that step in the shaft. But if that's the looks of it, it's not something that's going to put you off, then it's definitely worth considering. And it's also available chrome, matte black, and gloss black finishes.
Okay, so just winding the clock back, I can remember when this first came on the market, and you think, stability putter shafts, that's a great idea. The only one drawback with it was that you do need to go from a very wide top of the shaft, but down to the parallel tip section very, very quickly in that one step. Yeah. So if you look down the shaft and you can't accept that, the KBS have other putter shafts which you will be able to accept.
Yeah.
Okay, so on to the CT Tour. the KBS, they make the sea taper very, very stout, harsh feeling iron shaft. What do you think yourself?
Yeah, every time I've hit them, especially in like a stiff or an X, they are so strong. Mm-hmm. Don't get me wrong, for guys who've got a little bit more speed than myself, a little bit brisker action, then yeah, they're great. But for me, they always feel a little bit strong.
So you really don't get a loose feel with this shaft. We've just been talking about the one-step shaft, that it's only got one step in the middle. This doesn't have any step at all. It's just a continuous taper all the way down. So you know, if that step really draws your eye, you can't accept it, this would be a great alternative, as long as you like that real stout feel to it.
Yeah, so you can see it designed originally to cope with increased head weights. Again, your bigger footprint maybe, or putters that have had weight increase in the club head. I've been a stock shaft in TaylorMade putters as well, so obviously it's a good option if TaylorMade are going to be using it. I think the big thing is that you with this, Simon, is you're not going to get that loose feel, are you? Because like I said, when we discussed it in the iron market, they are strong, that stout feel. So the benefit of that is there's no looseness. You don't feel like you're not losing control of it because they're so strong.
Okay, and a firm favourite of Rory McIlroy and of DJ, so that shaft has won a bunch of money out there on tour. And then the last, okay, so the KBS Tour. The mothership of KBS is the Tour iron shaft. That's the shaft that everything else in the family has ever come from. This is the putter shaft that's been spurned from it.
Yeah, and obviously a stock shaft for the TaylorMade Spider putters, which has been a huge success, haven't they? Mm-hmm. Obviously now, I think you're going to get a little bit of smooth, a bit more responsive feel for this, a little bit more feedback through the hands than what we said on the previous there with the C-taper version. I think the big one of this is 124 gram weight. So you're looking at like people think, oh, this is going to be a lot lighter. It actually isn't, is it, Simon? So you've also still got that weight, which gives you a good feel, because I think when you get a little bit more weight on the club shaft, you can also feel where the club head is. It makes it a little bit more stable, doesn't it?
Okay, and it is a stepped shaft as well, so it's not a straight taper.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we wrap all of this up? I think what I've learned out of it, Neil, is that if you're going to buy a putter and you want to absolutely optimise performance, or if you've got an old favourite putter that you want to bring back to life, a really good fitting and paying a huge amount of attention to which shaft or which grip you buy is actually really, really important.
Yeah, definitely, because it's only going to maximise your performance, isn't it? I dare say you need to look at how big your miss is on the club face, and then put these into play and you'll definitely see a difference.
Brilliant. Okay, so there's a ton of information there. If you've liked the video, hit the like and subscribe button. If you've got any comments or questions, leave them below. We promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.